back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Let's say that we've done some sort of scientific trial. We have 1,000 results and we want to see how those results are distributed. Typically people try and do this using the frequency function, which is very difficult to do. But let me show you the initial problem. If we would just build a chart from this data. So I'll choose all of the data and use insert chart and say that we want a line chart. We just get a random mess of data. The points are all over the place. And people say, well, wait a second, you should sort the chart. So let me go back and sort the original data set. And then we just get a line. It really doesn't tell us exactly what the distribution is. So let me delete this chart. And what I'm going to do, rather than try and use the frequency function, is I'm going to create a pivot table. Data, pivot table, and pivot chart report. I'll click finish. And I'm going to take the trial result to both the row fields, which are going to give me all of those numbers again, and then copy it again to the data items here and change it to be a count. Instead of a sum, I want to see the count. I want to see how many occurred in each one. Well, right now, of course, I have the original data set with just one next to every single trial. But here's the cool thing. We're going to right-click on the first number, choose Group and Show Detail, and then Group, and say that we want to group these up into bins starting at 10. So maybe I go from negative 40 up to 150 in groups of 10, click OK, and now I get a beautiful distribution chart showing each result. When I create a chart out of this, maybe I'll create a column chart, and we have a great distribution of all the different values. So rather than try and use the frequency function, which is an array formula, rather difficult to use, you can create a pivot table and use the group option to group your results up into various bins. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.